Labor went on the front foot today, calling the PM out for failing to adequately denounce violent protests.
And he does that with this dangerous dog-whistling doublespeak that we see from him.
I can't think of another Prime Minister, Labor or Liberal, over modern history who wouldn't have just come out and unequivocally said in Australia, that is not on. No qualifications, no caveats.
Shadow Ministers critical of Scott Morrison for these comments.
There are many people who are feeling frustrated. I mean, over the last couple of years, governments have been telling Australians what to do. I have sympathy for Australians who've had a gutful of governments telling them what to do.
We've got a bit used to governments telling us what to do over the last couple of years.
The rest of us see the kind of violent politics that have emerged in the United States in the last couple of years, and we want to reject it. And the Prime Minister seems to want to embrace.
Labor might have been on the offence over the PM's rhetoric, but it was playing defence on the economy.
So we haven't finalised our full suite of policies, as you'd appreciate. There is still at least two budget updates between now and the election.
Inviting election charge attacks from the government.
Well, this morning, the Shadow Treasurer, Jim Chalmers, confirmed Australians' worst fears, and that is high taxes continue to be in Labor's DNA.
Parliament returns tomorrow for the final sitting fortnight before the end of the year. And Monday will also be the last full day in the chair for House of Reps Speaker Tony Smith.
Which has sort of led us down this alleyway that we're going to need to reverse out of.
Widely regarded as the best speaker in living memory. The chamber will choose his successor on Tuesday. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.